Want to know the secret to making reels and YouTube shorts that grab attention in the first 3 seconds? In this video, I'll show you how to edit short form vertical content inside CapCut to make your content stand out and help you grow your channel quickly. Let's do it. Now, just because we're editing videos for mobile doesn't mean we're editing them on mobile. The desktop version of CapCut is by far the most powerful and feature-rich version of the software, which is why I strongly recommend doing this entirely within the desktop software. Now, editing reels is a similar process to editing normal 16:9 videos, with a few exceptions that I want to point out in this video. As you can see, I've got my video track here, and this is the opening that you saw at the start of this video. What I'm going to do is drag that down onto my timeline. And as you'll see, that is in the 16:9 format. So the first step we're going to take is changing that. Here in the player window under ratio, if you click that and then scroll down to 9:16 and select it, this will convert it to a vertical 9:16 window, which will display perfectly on a smartphone screen. Now in the video menu under transform, you'll want to increase the scale until the frame hits the top and bottom of our new vertical frame, which is about there. Now, when you're filming, you'll want to make sure you allow for this and have plenty of space top, bottom, left, and right. So when you do scale or zoom the video in, it's not too zoomed in to the point that it's uncomfortable. Next, you'll want to reposition it by clicking and dragging the video until it looks like you're roughly in the middle. Now, throughout a video, you're probably going to move a bit to the left and right throughout. So what I usually do is I will skim across the timeline. And as you can see, I've moved slightly to this side as I go further into this clip. So what I want to do is choose the average position, which I think would be about here. I'm clicking and dragging to adjust. Okay, that looks nice and centered. You can always change this later if need be. Now, since I recorded audio externally, I'm going to drag my audio file down here onto the timeline, select the two clips and right click, then sync video and audio, which it will do automatically. I'm going to turn down the inbuilt sound on the video track, cut off the top and tail, and I'm going to make my tracks nice and big, so I'll change both of these to tall. Now, personally, I like color correcting at the very start of my videos just to get more of a sense of what the end product is going to look like. However, you can do this at any point you like. So if you're with me and you want to do it now, click on your clip and head up to adjustment and make the changes your clip needs. I like turning the saturation right up so it's colorful. Then I'll adjust the warmth so it's not too warm, and maybe the tint a bit because I'm seeing a bit of pink there, as well as bring the contrast down. And that's looking good. Before, after, before, after. Okay, now back to the editing. So I'm just doing a short one here in this video as an example, and it is the opening 15 seconds of this video. So what I'm going to do is zoom in using the plus button on the keyboard. And now it's time to do some ripple editing. And you can do that by pressing Q on the keyboard to delete left. I'm going to go to the end of this first line here and press S to split all tracks. Then I'll go up to the next good line that I know I want to cut to, which is about here. I'll just pinpoint it by pressing left and right on the keyboard and Q again. Ripple editing using your keyboard will double your editing speed at the bare minimum, so I definitely recommend giving it a go. If you want to know which shortcuts I use, feel free to download my free CapCut keyboard shortcut cheat sheet down below. So now I will go ahead and cut up the rest of this clip so it's nice and punchy. Okay, so I've got three main sections here. But one thing you want to keep in mind when editing shorts and reels that you might not necessarily do when editing longer form content is minimizing pauses as much as possible. So if I zoom right in here to my transition point, I can see I've got a few frames of silence. So if I watch that back, seconds in this video, a pause just felt like a few milliseconds too long. And attention spans online are so short, so every millisecond you can reduce from your video, you should. So I'm going to trim out these frames, move across and remove these. Let's watch it back. Seconds in this video. That's better. Now I'll do the same with the other cut point. You can see here we've got some big silence points. I think we can make this a lot punchier. So I'm going to ripple edit this. Let's watch it back.
And CapCut to make your
Great. Now, one way of making reels punchier is literally punching in and punching out from line to line to create a more dynamic and exciting video. So to do that, what I'm going to do is select this middle clip here. So I'm going to start on the slightly wider shot at the start and at the end, but I want the middle clip to punch in. So what I'm going to do is head back over here to video, and I'm going to increase the scale even more. Let's make it about 380. And I'm going to move it down. But here's one thing that you may not know that will make this transition from this wider shot to the close-up even more natural and almost feel like the cut isn't noticeable at all. And what that little secret is lining up the eyelines. Now, when I go between the middle and last shots, keep an eye on where my eyeline's at. So I'm going to scroll across with the right arrow. And as you can see, my mouse is right there on my eyeline, but then in the next shot, it's on my nose. This tells me that the eyelines are inconsistent, and when the eyelines are inconsistent, it means your audience is going to have to put in extra work looking up and down and all around every time you change shots. Whereas an essential part of good reel editing is keeping the eyelines in the exact same horizontal and vertical plane the whole time, regardless of the level of zoom. So to fix this, I'm going to drag this middle shot up. Now I'll go between the two again, and I'm going to put the point of my mouse right in between my two eyes. Now I'll go back to the wide shot. I can see it's now a bit high, and I'm going to keep adjusting it until the eyelines line up. I'm almost there. There we go. I think that is a good match. So if you are punching in and out, I'd recommend this technique, just hitting left and right on your keyboard at the split point between the two shots to line up the eyeline as best you can from shot to shot. This won't always be possible on both ends of every cut. If I go back to the start of this, maybe there's a little bit of a change there, but it's still pretty good. So do your best to find a happy medium where the eyelines stay roughly at the same point from shot to shot. Now when I play that back, that cut feels seamless. And while you can get fancy with these transitions from shot to shot in CapCut, they've got an entire transitions menu of fancy, paid, and free transition effects. I actually find they don't work as well as a clean cut, so let's take a look at this one. That was okay, but when cutting between two shots that are exactly the same, it looks a little bit weird. But use your best judgment based on what looks good with your video. Now the next thing I'm going to do is add animated captions to this reel so they play in sync with my words. Now to add these captions, head up to Captions in the top left menu, and on the left hand side, click Templates. As you'll see, CapCut has a really big library of template presets, many of them paid, but there are also a bunch of free ones as well to choose from, which are a bit on the simpler side. So if you want fancy ones, then I would recommend upgrading to CapCut Pro. To preview a caption, just hover over it and it will animate in the thumbnail area, and take a look through and see which one you like best. You can find them here sorted by the type of caption. So if you want single line only, you can do that. Or if you want multiple on one line, or if you want captions that have inbuilt emojis, you can do that as well. I'm going to go with a nice and simple one. This looks good, so I'm going to click it and now generate captions. A few seconds later, it will add this captions track to the top layer of the timeline. And these captions can be highly customized, so I would recommend increasing the font size a little bit so they are easily visible to everyone. Don't go too big, but at least size 16. And now what I'm going to do is, with the apply to all button checked, I'm going to drag this up so it's dead centered in the middle of our window. And the reason you want to keep your text centered in your reels is to minimize the amount your audience has to look around the frame to consume the entire video. So right now, my eyes are here and the captions are here, making it a very minimal path that your eyes have to travel between the two. Whereas if the captions were right down the bottom and my mouth was up here or over here, suddenly as an audience member, you're doing a lot more work to keep up. And when you start adding different layers of graphics and highly complex information to the theme of your reel, that's when it becomes too overwhelming and your audience simply won't take it in. Now, CapCut may or may not get the text transcription right from your video, and if it doesn't, that's fine. All you need to do is head up to Captions here and you can just click to edit. Otherwise, this transcription does look pretty good. Again, you can get a lot more customization out of these captions under the text menu if you wanted to, say, change the template to something else or adjust the color of the text, the font size, the font, and so on. Next, let's spice up this reel by animating some images in sync with what I'm talking about. So I've gone ahead and imported some graphics with clear backgrounds. So if you do want to do this, just make sure the images have a clear background for best effect. Now, firstly, what I'm thinking is having Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube Shorts pop up as I'm saying my opening line. So to add them to the timeline, just click and drag, and CapCut will automatically make a new layer. And for this effect, I'm going to drag all three onto three separate layers. As you can see, the sizes are pretty different, but that's okay. It's very easy to resize by just clicking and resizing. Okay, so I'm going to go to the first point. I want them to pop up, and that's going to be right around the word reels. That's where I want Instagram to first pop up. And I'm going to play with the positioning. Let's try it here. I'll move the timeline along. Next, I want TikTok to pop in. So I'll have that pop up down here. And then finally, YouTube is the third one. And I'll reposition that and resize it. So it's here. Then I want all of them to finish right around here. So I'll drag the end of them so they disappear right at this point. And let's take a look. Nice. Now we're going to go for something fancier. This time when I mention CapCut later in the reel, I'm going to just adjust that and reposition it. But this time what I'm going to do is animate this in, which is super easy. Just head up to animation in the top right and choose from the various animation presets. Again, some of them are free and some are paid. The one I want is slide up, and that's a free one. That looks great. I'm going to adjust the length of this so it's a bit faster. Next, to animate it out, select out, and the opposite of slide up is going to be slide down. Now let's watch that back. Fantastic. Now I'm going to take it up a level and make an image pop up behind me. So to achieve this effect, what I'm going to do is hold down Option on my keyboard, then click and drag my video up, which will duplicate it. So we have two layers with the exact same video. Now up here under video, I'm going to choose remove background. And yes, this is another paid feature. And I'm simply just going to click auto removal. Next, I'm going to import my image that I want to display behind me and click and drag it down. And I'm going to very carefully place it in between my two video layers that I just duplicated. As you can see, this is now behind me. Now, all I need to do to animate this in is scale it up so it fits the frame that I want it to fit, which is about there. I'm going to adjust the start and end point on the timeline, so it's now in sync with me talking about vertical content. Finally, all I'm going to do is animate that in the same way I animated in the CapCut logo, which was under animation, choosing slide up and slide down. And let's take a look. That looks seriously awesome. Just remember, when you're working with so many different layers, here we've got about 7 different layers, that whatever is on the very top layer is going to be visible. So if you want to hide something underneath something else, let's say we wanted to hide TikTok underneath our caption track, just drag it down, and as you can see, that is now behind the captions. I always like to add emojis to my videos. To do that, just head over to text, then default text, and add to track. Now in this default text box, copy and paste an emoji, or if you're working with an Apple keyboard that has a customized shortcut like I do, I'm going to press that button to bring up the emoji menu and select the one I want, which is this one, and I've got an emoji. Again, you can just copy paste an emoji from another app if you don't have that shortcut. So what I'm going to do is scale that up, and I want to actually place that behind my text, so I'm going to drag it down on the timeline. And just like everything else, you can animate emojis in and out by clicking animation, then under the in animation, choose an animation style you like. I'm going to choose bounce in with a duration of 0.1 of a second. And under the out animation, I'll select bounce out and set that to 0.1 of a second. And let's take a look. Great. Final step really is to add sound effects and music to really bring this reel to life for those that are in fact watching with sound, which is probably going to be like 50% or less of people, but it's still a good idea to put time into this as the icing on the cake of your epic reel. Now, while CapCut does have an audio section where it does offer a couple of music tracks and sound effects, I have heard mixed reviews of these in terms of copyright issues and videos being flagged on YouTube, which is why personally, at this point in time, I can't recommend doing this. Unless it's for personal use, then go ahead. Otherwise, I would suggest a platform like Epidemic Sound, which has been my go-to for many years and has a huge library of amazing royalty-free tracks that won't get flagged on YouTube, and they really do have tracks for every type of mood and video, as well as an entire sound effects library. If you want catchy sounds for your transitions, you'll find them here where you can preview them and download them to your computer. So if you have found either music or sound effects you like, after importing them into your project, simply click and drag them down to the bottom layer of the timeline and adjust the sound levels by hovering over this white line, clicking and dragging it down. I'd recommend taking it to around minus 30. Once you're done, all we need to do now is export our reel. So if you head up to the blue button at the top right and click it, here we can give our exported video a name and choose a save location. I recommend keeping the resolution at whatever you shot your video at. So for me, I shot at 4K, so I'm going to leave it at 4K. If you shot at 1080p, however, then you want to choose 1080p. With the bitrate, you can leave it at recommended and the codec as H.264. Then for format and frame rate, here I'm exporting my video as a MOV format with a frame rate of 50 FPS because again, that's what I shot my video at, but you should export yours at whichever frame rate you shot yours at. Once these settings are set, go ahead and click export and we're done. Want to know the secret to making reels and YouTube shorts that grab attention in the first 3 seconds? In this video, I'll show you how to edit short form vertical content inside CapCut to make your content stand out and help you grow your channel quickly. If you want to learn the entire CapCut interface for editing on desktop, feel free to check out my Beginner to Pro Editing Masterclass, where I cover every step of the journey to making professional videos that stand out on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, or wherever you want to post them. You can learn more about that down below. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If there's anything else you want to add about editing reels inside CapCut, let me know down below. And if you consider yourself a more experienced editor, you'll be happy to know that CapCut has just released a whole bunch of features for intermediate to advanced editors. In this video here, I'll go through my top 5 favorite features that CapCut had just released that will make your editing experience 1,000 times better.